What's up, everybody? Today I'm doing a Drain Gang tier list. Okay, this is going to be the Drain Gang tier list of all of our favorite terrorist organization, Drain Gang, GTBSG, right? Shield Gang, Gravity Boys. You know how it is. I'm going to be doing all their albums, all the collab albums, right? The collective ones, Late albums, Tie Boy albums, Echo albums. We're going to have some bootlegs in there like Beauty Sleep, Glue 2, Blade City, the important ones, White Armor's album that nobody fucking talks about. And we're going to have Young Sherman's EP slash album as well. Going to do all of it. I also have a few EPs in here, at least the ones that I think are worth talking about that are like more than like two songs. So let's just get straight into it. And yeah, what's up? This is me while editing. I'm just here to let you guys know throughout sometimes when I say the score, where I say stuff, the audio just cut out because OBS is preying on my fucking downfall. So I'm apologize for that. I put the letter, like the score I give the album, on screen, so just pay attention to that. Anyways, thanks for watching. Bye. So here's the tier list we got going on. Let's actually change this up, but here's all the albums, because I'll be like rating these as well as we do this, right? So here's what we got. We got 4 out of 10, the 10 out of 10. It's gonna be pretty straightforward in terms of rating. I don't think there is a Blade or Drain Gang album in general that is lower than a 4. I'm gonna be real, I'm extremely biased. I love the shit out of Drain Gang. So a lot of these, be real, a lot of these are going to be 8 or higher because I just love them. So let's start first off with all the collab projects. So obviously the first would be Gravity Boy Shield Gang compilation. That is the first comp album of the whole collective. It is still very much ingrained in their original cloud rap, kind of auto-tune heavy sound, much like the Glue era and the stuff before and right immediately after it. I absolutely love every single song in here. It's full of so many bangers. There's Bleach, there's Blade City, there's Be With You, I think that's the Tie Boy track. Hold Them Down Like Gravity. Like, come on, it's just, it's so stacked. It's damn near perfect. I do think, I'm gonna be real, I think Diamonds is definitely the weakest track on that whole album. I think Black Race features is kind of whatever, especially when he has other songs with Blade, like Friday Night, that are pretty fucking awesome. Gravity Boy Shield Gang is a phenomenal starting point. It's so drenched in just that dense cloud rap atmosphere that you love to see from Drain Gang. I love the absolute shit out of it. I'd probably throw it in S tier, or my bad, 9 out of 10 for sure. I think it's a phenomenal project with very little shortcomings and just has such a dense, amazing atmosphere and a near flawless track list of early Drain Gang. All right, let's move on then to the other collab albums. So we have Trash Island. I'm gonna be real, I don't really like Trash Island. Like, let's just pull this shit up right now. Like, the first track's not bad. Victim, Western Union, The Void. It's really short, I'll give it that. It doesn't take too much time, right? 22 minutes, 8 songs, in and out. But it's kind of split. I think like half the songs are good and half the songs are kind of whatever. I wouldn't say they're all any bad ones. It's kind of whatever. It's take it or leave it for me. I'd probably throw it in 6 out of 10 tier. It's not something I go back to in full, you feel me? Like, I'll listen to Victim, I'll listen to Western Union, but am I gonna go back and listen to all of Trash Island? Fuck no, probably not. It feels half baked sometimes. So D&G is like twice the length of Trash Island, and it was a bit later in the whole Drain Gang, you know, fucking multiverse or whatever. There are some exceptional tracks on here. GTR, Dumpster Baby, Stalker, I absolutely love. Happily Ever After is pretty good too. Botox Lips, Cinderella as well, First Crush, Black Boy as well. There are a lot of good songs in here, but damn does this shit feel long. Oh my god. If you listen to D&G in full, man, it's fucking draining. Maybe that's intentional. It kind of is a fucking slog to get through. It is not that enjoyable as a full album. There are some absolute top tier Blade, Echo, and Tie Boy tracks on D&G, and it's very just kind of whatever for me. It's okay, right? Let's get this straight first. 5 out of 10 does not mean bad. It just means okay. 4 out of 10 means it's kind of shit. But 6 out of 10 is like, it's all right. It's like, there's some redeemable, like pretty interesting stuff. 5 out of 10 is just okay. I think it's just so half and half with D&G for me. There are some amazing songs, but it only makes up like half the track list, and the other half is just really whatever. Its track listing just makes it like way more of a slog to get through, and I just don't enjoy it that much. I'd rather listen to Trash Island, you feel me? All right, moving on. Let's do Young Sherman's album and White Armor's album. So Young Sherman's album, fuck, what was it called? Goddamn. So I think it's technically an EP. That's what it says on Spotify. Innocence. It's cool. I mean, it's nothing too crazy. It just feels like an instrumental palette. It's not bad at all. It's pretty enjoyable. But I can't help but feel that on a lot of these tracks, I'm just envisioning fucking, I'm like, Blade, save me, Blade. Right? Like, I just imagine somebody on it. And it feels like the tracks feel a bit empty because of that. But it's so short. It's just an EP. And it's kind of whatever. I'd probably put in 6 out of 10. Now, this is Slept On. This is White Armor's only album It's called Music for Weddings. It's fantastic. It is relatively different than White Armor production we usually hear on Dranging stuff. I'd say it's closer to like kind of Crest sort of production than like Glue for sure, but it's much more ambient. It's much calmer. The name of the album is Music for Weddings, and I think that that's a perfect description of it. It's calming, it's beautiful, and it's serene as hell. I will say it all kind of meshes into each other, and I can't really name a specific track as being more rememberable than another, but the whole album is just a completely pleasant and nice experience that I highly recommend people check out. It's a very unique entry in the Drangang fucking cinematic universe that people don't ever bring up. But Music for Weddings is a calming, beautiful, meditative album, and I highly recommend check it out. Probably 7 out of 10. It does feel kind of like whatever, right? Like, I don't think I'll revisit it too much, but I do think it is quite good. I think next we'll move on to Ty Boy's albums. So here's the thing with Ty Boy. Drangang fans, half of them don't even listen to Ty Boy at all, and he just gets shit on. Also, he unfortunately picked the name Goon before Goon became Gooning. So I feel bad for bro. Ty Boy has 5, in my opinion, projects that we need to mention. Lord of the Jewels, Return of the Goon, Tiger, of course, SOS, which is an EP, and then we have, of course, Legendary Member and Back to Life. Ty Boy, here's my general thing on Ty Boy. Ty Boy feels like he's always half a step behind Blade and Echo. Ever feel like Ty Boy is really ever doing his own thing? He's kind of always doing what Blade is doing, but giving his own flair to it. You feel me? Like, it feels very intertwined. Ty Boy's progression seems very close to Blade's progression as an artist. I don't hate him for that. I find his music, it's like Blade, but way more braggadocious, way more about, you know, the Louis, the Vinny, all that shit. I'm just way less interested in it in comparison to something like Blade. That being said, as I said before, people don't give him enough credit. People don't listen to him. And it's a shame because some of the stuff is pretty fucking good. Let's start off with Tiger. Here's the thing. If you like Glue and you haven't listened to Tiger, you're doing yourself a huge disservice, okay? Tiger is the closest Drangang project to Glue, in my opinion. Of official releases, it's the closest we get. Tiger is my favorite Ty Boy album. It's incredibly dense. It has that old cloud rap sound. Ty Boy has his own flair on it. I think it's great. It's a really good album from start to finish. It just feels like a companion piece to Glue. It's an album that's dense. It just feels like Ty Boy's take on their older Glue sound. And I'd probably give it an 8 out of 10. Thanks. There's some tracks on there that I'm not so crazy about, but I think Tiger is a good ass album. All right, let's talk about this. Now, Lord of the Jewels, Return of the Goon is like a forgotten, it's the lost media of Drangang stuff because it's not on Spotify. I don't even think Ty Boy remembers he made this shit. Ty Boy just is not taking himself seriously, okay? Ty Boy does not give a single shit on Lord of the Jewels, Return of the Goon. He just doesn't give a fuck. And I respect it. That being said, there are 2-ish songs on here that are actually pretty catchy, but the rest is kind of like, what the fuck is bro talking about? It's interesting. I think it's hated too much, and it's not that bad, but it's definitely not that good. So I'd probably put in 6 out of 10. Like, Don't Dance and 180 are top tier Ty Boy tracks and really good Drangang tracks, but they're slept on because nobody fucking listens to this shit. But those aren't bad, or those are actually really good. But the rest of the album is just kind of, you know, it's just kind of whatever. Like, I don't really give a fuck. Next, we have SOS. Now, SOS is honestly just super forgettable. From all the times I listened to it, it's not bad by any means. It's cool. But that's the most I describe it. It's cool. And I just think it's forgettable. I'd throw it in fucking 5. There's some good songs on there, but it's so short and it's really just kind of a whatever album. Okay, Legendary Member. I know a lot of people like me personally. I think the features easily overshadow Ty Boy on any track there is features on. On a lot of the songs, in my opinion, they're so fucking boring. It just feels super basic, super whatever. And the whole album, I really like, I've listened to it at this point like 4 or 5 times. I always just think this is boring as shit. Ty Boy sounds like he's asleep on half the songs, and I'm always just waiting for the tracks with the features because I think they're so much better. It's just really kind of whatever for me, and it's just super underwhelming, especially in comparison to something like Tiger. It's just kind of whatever. I really don't give a fuck about it. Like, I'm gonna just be straight up, it's probably my least favorite Drangang project easily. I'm throwing in 4 out of 10. Sorry if you like Legendary Member, more power to you, but it's just not for me. Back to Life, because at least something like Lord of the Jewels, Return of the Goon, I remember it, you feel me? There are those moments where I'm really like, yeah. But Back to Life, I just don't fucking care. We put Legendary Member in 5 and Back to Life in 4. It's really just kind of whatever. I don't really give a fuck about Back to Life. It's decent, it's okay, but it's nothing memorable, and it cements to me that Ty Boy, I just feel like he doesn't know what to fucking do on his own projects half the time. Maybe I'm too much of a Ty Boy hater though. If you like Ty Boy, if you like Back to Life and Legendary Member, tell me why in the comments below. I'm interested to hear about that. Out of Fresca. Y'all fuck with Fresca? Fresca is some good shit. Y'all gotta try that. Okay, moving on. Let's go to Echo with his three projects technically, because we have Beauty Sleep on here. If there's a drinking tier list and it doesn't have Beauty Sleep, you're a fake fucking fan. That's all I'm saying. Beauty Sleep is one of the best drinking projects. For those who don't know, for the uninitiated, Beauty Sleep is a bootleg made by the fans. It was made before E came out, and pretty much it's a collection of all his singles, some leaked songs. It has the entire first Crush like songs. It has AAA Powerline, because it was at a time when AAA Powerline was just a single, which was way before E came out. So it's that collection of Echo's music put into a single project by fans. Despite being a bootleg, feels really well made, and a lot of the times the track seems to flow together, and despite, you know, fans just throwing it together, it has its own identity and atmosphere, which is crazy to think because it's a bootleg. The thing with bootlegs is there's different iterations, and I can come up with my own bootleg, you can come up with your bootleg. It just ends up being there's no like official this version, because there's songs on Beauty Sleep that are from DNG, Blackboy's on here, AAA Powerline's on here, right? And there's these, some of these songs on here I really feel like fuck up the atmosphere and vibe a bit. I don't think Blackboy should be on here, even though I think the lyrics fit a lot of what's happening on Beauty Sleep. It just production-wise does not match a lot of them. A lot of the tracks on here are really early Echo stuff. For those who don't know, early Echo sound is very, I can only really describe it as digital. It's dense, it's atmospheric. A lot of the tracks on here don't have Echo singing at all. They're literally just ambient music. The final track on here is Centerfold, and you can find it on YouTube. It's called like 000. It's a 7-minute ambient song, and it's amazing. It's beautiful, it's haunting, and that's a lot of this album. It's depressing, it's haunting, it's atmospheric, it's fucking fuzzy and digital as hell. So when we have songs like Hold Me Down Like Gravity or Play 'Em Like Atari or Mirage, those really do fit into this sort of sound. They have the same production and they really match all these other atmospheric tracks, and they fit the more atmospheric tracks that also have singing like Exposed and stuff like that, or I'm All Right, much better, right? So something like Blackboy or DNG and Stalker, which I love all those songs, right? They feel a bit out of place. Even like the Crush Resist series on here feels like it fits somewhat. Despite there being a few songs I feel like maybe don't fit, they barely take away from the album. It's only 44 minutes. There's a lot of tracks. It goes by so fast and it's so haunting and beautiful. It's truly one of the most unique and, in my opinion, the best Drain Gang projects easily. I just feel like there's a few things holding it back. That being said though, it's a bootleg. I mean, I can make my own version where I take a few of the tracks out and boom, my own version of Beauty Sleep. But it is definitely one of the best Drain Gang projects. You should definitely check it out if you like Echo, and if you haven't, you're sleeping on it. I'm putting it in 9 out of 10. Okay, next we have E. This is in arguably maybe the most popular Drain Gang album. I think Crest might be more popular. I feel like in terms of the wide audience, this is the most approachable and popular one. Not my favorite. I do think it's really good though. In E, it's floaty, it's poppy, but unlike Beauty Sleep where it felt very drenched in like kind of this fucking depression, E is pretty lively and it feels more like a manic high, right? I think it's beautiful. I think the message Echo has on a lot of these about kind of just about his race and feeling just completely out of place in Sweden. I think Blue Eyes is one of the best Drain Gang songs. I think it's one of maybe probably the best closer from any Drain Gang album. It's heartbreaking, it's beautiful, and it's just this mix of drug abuse and feeling completely disassociated with those around you and this downward spiral that it causes that makes E beautiful. That being said, I think Time, the second to last song on the album, feels out of place. I really wish it was released as a single and it just wasn't on the album. I think if it wasn't on the album, it would be perfect. I'm gonna put it in 9 and I'll put it there. I think that's a great place for E. So now we have Echo's last project, you know, large quotations, Pixie. I got Pixie on CD, one of the best CDs I've ever purchased. The packaging on that shit, you can see the Pixie poster, it's amazing. Anyways, Pixie, it's an EP, it's really short. One thing I will say, and this applies to E too, both E and Pixie have amazing bonus tracks that just aren't on streaming, but the bonus tracks on physical, you can find them on YouTube. Amazing. Oh my god, the bonus track for Pixie is fucking beautiful. It's one of Echo's best. Pixie is almost like a return to form, in my opinion. It feels like Echo blending perfectly his newer kind of, you know, higher pitch, more singing approach with this more rough sound that we heard on like Crush Resist. I think the final track on Pixie is a perfect marriage of that, where Echo is more manic, like Pixie-like vocals, and then this like industrial, really heavy electronic sound. And I think it works really well. That being said, it's a really short EP. it feels like it's doing a lot of different things, and I feel like on almost every track, Echo's just experimenting. With all that though, it's still incredibly entertaining, fun to listen to, and it never feels that long, which it isn't, you know, it's like 18 minutes, but it doesn't even feel like that. It feels like it goes by so fast. I do think it is all over the place, and I just wish it was longer, dude. I wish we had more of what the final track sounded like. I just wish Big Air, more Big Air, please, Echo. I'm gonna put in 8. I think it's quite good. I don't know, it feels like forgotten. A lot of people are like, Echo only has one album, it's E, he hasn't dropped anything else. It's like a Frank Ocean situation, right? People who are really into Frank Ocean are always like, we're never getting another Frank Ocean project. And they like only listen to Blonde and Channel Orange. Frank Ocean has Endless and fucking Nostalgia Ultra. And I know half of you Frank Ocean fans don't fucking listen to Endless. Arguably, it's fucking on par, if not better than Blonde. Echo is very similar. Echo has Beauty Sleep and Pixie, which are fantastic. And in my opinion, damn near on par, if not better. And people just don't give a fuck. All right, let's move into some of these like kind of random ones I got here. I have a few bootlegs here, you can see. So I have Summertime Demos, which is a recent bootleg. It's this one right here. Pretty much what Summertime Demos is, it's pretty much a B-sides to Crest. It's a bunch of tracks that were made for Crest or during the Crest sort of production that never made it. Now, if you find this on YouTube, there's, I think, 6 or 7 tracks, but there's really only 2. Those 2 are pretty nice, and I could have easily seen them fitting on Crest, and they're very nice, beautiful Crest sounding track. The rest, super unfinished, super whatever tracks that kind of suck ass, and it feels very like thrown together by the fans. It's really whatever. If you like Crest, check it out, but you'll probably never return to it. I just wanted to mention it because I feel like it's relevant. It's the newest bootleg, and a lot of people really like Crest, but not too many people talk about it. Here's the Completionist's Drainer album, Blade City. You can find it on RYM. The 2 reviews for Blade City on RYM, a modern retelling of Sisyphus, but instead of Sisyphus, it's Blade, and instead of a boulder, it's every single piece of auto-tune technology he can get his hands on. As far as I'm aware, I think every single piece of Blade-released music before Glue, and we're talking every, they even have the shit from when Blade and Echo were kids and were in that like screamo rock band. That shit is on here. Okay, do you realize how fucking weird that is? Is it good? It's kind of whatever. It's 2.5 hours long, and it is literally just everything. Okay, a lot of these other bootlegs have what Blade City has, because Blade City isn't like supposed to be like Beauty Sleep, where they're almost like the fans are making their own album. Blade City is just supposed to be like a, here's everything Blade has ever made before Glue. Here you go. Because of that, it's a slog to get through. It's not that fun to listen to because there's other bootlegs that do these other tracks that kind of just aren't even on albums way better. And it's fun. It's cool. The fact that it exists is really cool. But there's no reason to listen to it when we have other bootlegs that I'll mention soon and that I've already mentioned, because it's just, it's really whatever. It's a completionist album for Blade. I put it in 6 out of 10, but I do recommend checking it out if you're really into Drain Gang. Next, we have Remote Utopias. This is the only live album from Blade and Echo. Basically, the first half is Echo and the second half is Blade. Echo's half, mainly just E tracks, but he does do a live version of one of the Crush Resist songs, and it sounds fucking fantastic, so that's really cool. Echo's half is amazing. Every song almost blends into itself, and it's this light, dreamy atmosphere that was on E. And then it comes pummeling with the Crush Resist songs, and it's just an amazing live set. Blade set, on the other hand, not bad. He plays Oxygen live. That's huge. Oxygen, one of Blade's best songs, he plays live. But besides that, it's mainly tracks from Exeter, and you'll see later, I'm really not a fan of Exeter. And it's, Blade just sounds fucking half asleep on his live set. I'd probably throw it in a 6 out of... So this next bootleg is one that is slept on, that is goated, that you guys need to check out. It's called the GTB bootleg. It is pretty much a collection of all the Drain Gang stuff around the same time as GTBSG. I'm gonna be real, I think it's on par with the comp. The comp definitely flows a bit better because it's official. If it couldn't be fucking told already, I'm a very big fan of early Drain Gang. A lot of their best early songs from Ty Boy, from Echo, from Blade are all on here. And also the songs that they were featured on, so like Ice Floors, Snowman, right? Stuff like that. Friday Night, I think, is on here as well. There's also a few tracks that are just Young Sherman and White Armor, which are interesting. I'm putting it in, and I think I would put it over Gravity Boys. It just has more of that original cloud rap drain sound in comparison to even GTBSG comp. I think the GTB bootleg is just fantastic. It has some of my favorite songs. I will say, this being said, a lot of the songs on here you will find on Leap you will find on Glue 2. You will find on the Blade City bootleg comps, which I'll talk about why I don't have that on here in a minute. It's fantastic. You should check it out. It's, in my opinion, the best encapsulation of early Drangang. I feel like a lot of people listen to Blade City to get that early Drangang. Don't do that. If you're interested in early Drangang, go listen to the official GTBSG compilation and then listen to the fan-made GTB bootleg. This will give you a really good idea of the early Drangang sound. And if you're interested, of course, check out Beauty Sleep and another bootleg I'll talk about in a sec. All right, that leaves us with the big man himself, Blade, Drain CEO. I think we go in order. I think that's fair. Let's start with, of course, Glue. It's a 10. It's a fucking 10. I've listened to Glue God knows how many times at this point. Probably over 100 times. Glue is flawless. It's short. It's like less than 30 minutes. Every single song on here is just dense. It's cold. It's atmospheric as hell. Every track is so memorable, so catchy. Delete intro, one of Blade's best songs. Everlasting Flame, Spellbound, eBay, Shadow Face. Like, come on. Every song on Glue is flawless. I will say, I think some songs are like really like top tier songs, and then the rest of them are just right behind it. The quality is fucking insane across Glue, and it's easily one of the best Drangang albums. I think it's a perfect album. I love the ever living shit out of Glue. Now this carries over to our last bootleg we'll be talking about, Glue 2. So basically, for those who don't know, between Glue and Eversense, there was a album a lot of people speculate was supposed to drop called Rain World. Unfortunately, it never came out, which is a shame because it would have had songs, of course, like To Be Loved, Winter Soldier / Everything Can Go. If they did release, probably would have been some of Blade's best, easily. But in terms of bootlegs for Blade, Glue 2 is amazing, okay? I've listened to some of the Rain World bootlegs, but they really are kind of subpar. A lot of the tracks like the volumes are super different and they just don't really fit that well. But Glue 2, I don't know if the person who made it actually did, but I feel like all the audio for each track is leveled out, so it actually, you know, you don't have to fucking switch your volume up and down while you're listening. But Glue 2 has genuinely like all my favorite Blade songs, and it's all in a row. Like Glue, it's really short. Glue 2 has a perfect track list. It's 9 songs. I put this on myself, okay? Don't pay attention to everything, you can go. It's 9 songs. Like Glue, it's really short. It's a perfect track list of all of this older Blade stuff of right before Glue and right after Glue. Beautiful as the intro. Subaru, amazing. Crushed, amazing. Unlovable, probably the weakest track on here, but very, very good as well. And then this is just a run. 5 to 9 is perfect. Oxygen, amazing. Ghost Hands, one of Blade's best songs easily. One of his best flows, amazing. Blade City, so fucking good, dude. Blade City is so top tier, it's insane. Absolutely love Young Lean on here. I think he's able to match Blade perfectly with the beat. Cash In My Jeans, maybe my favorite Blade song. It's a shame that we never got a CDQ of it, but that being said, I think the weird like leak version we have of it almost adds a bit to the song, right? But it's so good. And Buildings as the outro is perfect. Buildings is one of the best Drangang songs. Ty Boy sounds amazing. Blade sounds amazing. Young Lean sounds amazing. And Glue 2 is just so perfect in my opinion. Every song is just so good and just feels like it's just getting better each fucking track. I think it's phenomenal. I think it's perfect. I like more than Glue, if I'm being honest. Easy 10 out of 10 for me. Glue 2. Fucking how do they do it? How do they do it? Like, it's just so good. Now let's move on to R.I.P. Blade. Fantastic EP. 5 songs. Pretty much all bangers. 7-Eleven is amazing, of course. Short. It's 5 tracks. Tracks that are phenomenal, that are worth checking out. Is it like the best thing I've ever heard from Blade? No. Is it the worst? Definitely not. It's kind of take it or leave it for me. But the quality's high. And it's very similar in vein to Working on Dying, AVP, kind of that sort of era. And I think it's for sure one of Blade's better kind of EP, like shorter albums. I think R.I.P. Blade is good, but you know, it's just kind of a short EP and there's not too much to write home about. I fucking forgot Eversense. I didn't forget, I just kind of looked over it. Eversense is a fucking 10. I like it more than Glue. Not Glue 2 though. Eversense is, in my opinion, still Blade's best album, official album, fully realized album from Blade, with one other being very close, which we'll talk about later. Eversense is cold. It's atmospheric. Blade's auto-tune, it doesn't mesh as well as with the production as Glue did, where it kind of blended in. His auto-tune makes him just sound cold and distant, which just aids in how fucking sad the album is. Ever since, there's no misses, straight fucking depression, and it's beautiful. It's a longing for something. And I think Skin, easily one of Blade's best, and easily his best outro, bar none, fucking no competition. It just feels like the most fully realized Dranging album, in my opinion, with an actual idea, with a start to finish track list that just feels really well put together. I love Ever Since, but yeah, Ever Since 10 out of 10 easily. So next, let's do AVP. I'm gonna be honest, I feel like it's a tiny bit slept on. People obviously know about it, but I feel like it either gets hated or just not mentioned a lot of the time. Area 51, 1 million, like, great songs, and I think it's pretty solid throughout. It's only what, like 8 songs or something. It's really short. It doesn't overstay its welcome at all. It's there, it's a fun time, it's in, it's out, and that's it. Pretty enjoyable. I put it in 7. Next, let's do Working on Dying. Of course, Working on Dying took the longest to grow on me out of any of the Blade albums, easily. The tread sort of style. Working on Dying, I think, is Blade. I'd said Lord of the Jewels, Return of the Goon was the least serious Tieboy. Working on Dying feels like the least serious Blade album. Blade feels very kind of like nonchalant, you know, he's like, I'm a nonchalant dreadhead, right? That's what Blade is on this album. Under Your Spell is one of Blade's best songs, easily. Come on now, how can you listen to Under Your Spell and not think that's top tier Blade? That being said, I do think there's some songs in here that are kind of just whatever. It's super short though. I don't know, it's like on par with AVP. I'll be real, I'll put it like 7 out of 10. Some of it's kind of whatever, but as a whole album, it's still very enjoyable from start to finish. It's short, it's in and out, it's a fun time. And Under Your Spell is one of Blade's best songs. So yeah, so we got Red Light and Ice Dancer next. Two of, I think, his most popular, right? Besides Crest. I don't know, some people either think Red Light's his best or his worst, which is kind of weird because I think it's good, but there are some fucking stinkers on here, dude. Nike Just Do It is easily Blade's worst fucking song, okay? I'd rather listen to Tony Hawk. Tony Hawk's at least funny. Blade always has cringy lyrics, okay? That's a given. He always does that. Usually, it's just the way he says it and the way it mixes with the production that I don't really give a fuck. Nike Just Do It is like cringy lyric after cringy lyric. It's very sparse in the production on that song, and it's cringe as fuck, and I do not like that song at all. Red Light feels like Ever Since, but Blade got his confidence back. It's a bit more fun to listen to. The track list is not nearly as consistent as like Glue or Ever Since, but that being said though, it is pretty solid throughout. And Fantano gave it a 0, which is a fucking crime. I give it like, okay, Ice Dancer. Ice Dancer also took a bit to grow on me. I know for a lot of people, it's their first Blade album and it's their favorite, but for me, I kind of realized I was hating a bit. The typical complaint people have, including myself, which I still do a bit, is the second half is weaker than the first. I do think that's true. The first like 10, 11 track run is damn near flawless. And I think the second half is a bit weaker. And people are always like, but Waster is on the second half. But Waster is on the bro, are you fucking dumb? I said the whole second half is a bit weaker. I think the difference in quality is not nearly as big as a lot of people make it out to be. For Nothing, Special Place, Waster, DG Jeans, like all those songs are really good. And I do think it's a bit less as good as the first half, but I think they're pretty quality, right? Definitely top tier shit. In my Blade video I made a while ago, first tier list, I said I didn't like the outro that much, Silent Boy. I do think it works. I feel like the second half is just a bit calmer than the first. I do feel like it is a tiny bit out of place, but it's an enjoyable, good outro, but not on par with fucking Skin or something like that. Ice Dancer's top tier though. It's one of Blade's funnest albums. It's very easy to get into, I think, after you listen to it a few times. And that being said, the lyrics are still pretty emotional and personal from Blade. I absolutely love it. I'd probably put it top of 9 out of 10. Oh wait, Over Beauty Sleep. Yeah, I probably would. Okay, moving on. I think Exeter, fucking 4 out of 10. Here's the thing with Exeter. It feels like Blade is trying to experiment, which you love to see from artists. Most artists, when they experiment on an album, most do not stick the landing. And this is the case for me with Blade. Blade is trying to experiment. He's really trying something new. Almost all the songs sound kind of different. But that being said, I don't think anything sticks. I think it all kind of sounds half-baked. It all kind of sounds whatever. And I just don't give a fuck about it. It's super short, but it's just so whatever, in my opinion. I put a 4 out of 10. Next, we have 333. 333 has grown on me a lot. Originally, when I've listened to it a few times, after like 3 listens, I was like, it's good, but it's not as good as like other stuff. But as I've listened to it more, I've realized this is probably top 4 or 5 Blade. 333 has a few songs on it that I do feel like are kind of whatever. But as a whole album, some of Blade's best songs, Hero My Story, Only One, come on. Like, and then Reality Surf, Noblest Strive, those are some of Blade's best songs. And I do think there are some tracks that are a bit weaker, of course. Like, the quality across the board isn't like Ever Since or Glue, in my opinion, where every single song is just fantastic. But it's pretty up there. Honestly, one of Blade's most emotional, most personal, and lyric-wise, one of his best albums, easily. And it's grown on me a lot. I'd honestly put 3.33. I think I'd give it a 9 out of 10. So I think the next one is it the Mech and Talk album? Fuck, what's it called? Dude, I'm a fake fan. Good Luck? Is it called Good Luck, right? I'm just saying it right now, I put in 7 out of 10. Like, the whole time I'm listening to Good Luck, I think it's called, I'm just like, right? You listen to Rainbow, how do you not nod your head to that? It's definitely the most stripped back production-wise you've heard Blade. It's the most kind of bare bones I think we've ever heard him. But I enjoy it a decent amount. I do think some of the tracks kind of just feel, I don't know, they feel empty. But there are some songs in here that I really do enjoy how Blade is mixed in with these kind of more softer, just kind of dance music. Oh, here's a big hitter. Crest, I put it in 10 out of 10. Oh, fuck, would I? Here's the thing with Crest. There's nothing wrong with it, in my opinion. Every single song on Crest is flawless. Blade and Echo just bounce off each other so well. They sound like angels serenading me. White Armor's production is just absolutely top tier. The Seven Star, I'm sorry, I forgot the name, but that song is fantastic. I never thought Blade would be able to make a 7 minute long song, but it sounds fantastic. White Meadow is one of my favorite Blade and Echo songs, and the whole album is just beautiful. For me, whenever I listen to one song off of Crest, I immediately want to listen to the whole album. Girls Just Want to Have Fun, Chaos Follows, White Meadow, come on. And this applies to The Fool as well. I put The Fool 10 out of 10. Here's the thing with The Fool. It's like the yin to Ever Since's yang. The Fool is Blade's, probably his best lyric-wise album. It's him reflecting on his past and how he's gotten to this point, seeing how he can move on in the future to be better. And at the same time, every song on here is a banger. It's this new style of Blade. It sounds so nice, well-produced, well-thought-out, and it's my favorite kind of new era of Blade. BBY is one of my favorite Blade songs. You got Trendy, Ego Baby. Every song on The Fool is just fantastic. I think The Fool is amazing. It feels like, besides Ever Since, the most well thought out album Blade has ever done. And I love everything about it. I think it's damn near perfect. Now we're at the newest three and the last three. So let's start with Spider. First off, Spider is honestly really fun. And I think it's an example of experimentation from Blade that lands much better than something like Exeter. And I think a lot of the times it's Blade kind of leaning more into this maybe like kind of punkish sound, and it sounds good. He's kind of manically going insane on the whole album. I honestly like it. I give it 8 out of 10. I think it got overhated a bit because it was different, it was new. But I think at this point, I do think it's pretty great. I think it's just manic, it's chaotic. And it's like that the whole album, and it's pretty consistent throughout. Psychos, Young Lean collab album, kind of more rock leaning the whole time. There are some good songs in here, but a few of them feel a bit underwhelming, like they could have been developed more. I'd probably give it like a... I'd give it like a 6. I think it's cool. I think it's enjoyable, but I really just wish it was longer. I wish it was thought out a bit more, because some of it definitely feels kind of whatever. And compared to what like Young Lean's done on like Johnson Leandor, it is even subpar to that in my opinion. So it's kind of whatever. And here we are with the newest one, Cold Visions. Here's the thing with Cold Visions. Cold Visions is maybe the worst case of recency bias I've ever seen in my fucking life. If you're on Last.fm, you know how like when you click on albums, there's the shout boxes, people type comments and stuff. I was right there, right when Cold Visions came out. I was looking at the shout box and I can't find it. I fucking looked for like 20 minutes, but I couldn't find it. Basically, you gotta take my word for it. Somebody basically was like, I think it's really good. I think Cold Visions is really good, but I still think Ever Since is better. And then one dude commented on that. This was like the day of release, by the way, and said like, you're just stuck in the past, nostalgia is blinding you. And I'm like, bro, the album came out today. Isn't recency bias fucking blinding you? Like, come on, I'm gonna be real. After listening to it a few times, the hype kind of dying down, it's a bit bloated, okay? It's not like the 30 song, every song banger that everybody was making out to be. It's Blade's longest album. It's an hour long. It has 2 outros. Only Blade can get away with it, my glorious king. There are a few tracks on here that are kind of whatever, and that's a given how long it is, right? It is surprising how many songs in here are very good, despite the length. The lyrics from Blade, I feel like you didn't give a fuck. That's fine though, it's a fun album. I feel like you really feel the length, right? Like Cold Visions, you really feel that it's a fucking hour long. And I think it's just overhyped, dude. Like, some of the songs in here are really kind of whatever. It's not like a flawless track list like Glue or Ever Since, or even like Crest or The Fool, right? Even Ice Dance. Ice Dancer is long. It's like 17 tracks, right? And that's a way better track list than Cold Vision. I think it's kind of overrated a bit. I would give it a 7 out of... I think Working on Dying is honestly more enjoyable because of its length. Don't get me wrong, there are great songs. I think the 2 outros are fantastic. Some of Blade's best. And if what the lyrics are saying are true, I think it was a great way to go out. It's a great album to end his career on. But I think it's overrated. That is my Drain Gang tier list. That is everything. That's all the single albums. That's the collab albums. That's White Armors. That's Bootlegs. everything. That is what I think about Drain Gang. I've been a fan of Drain Gang now for like 2-3 years. I love the hell out of Drain Gang. I've been listening to them fucking endlessly. It's been such a big part of my life since I found out about them. It's obvious from the list, but I'm very biased towards early Drain Gang. I think their cloud rap stuff is in general more interesting and better than their newer stuff. But that being said, I still think stuff like The Fool and Crest are top tier amazing albums. This is my Drain Gang tier list. Let me know in the comments below how you would rank these, or what maybe, I don't know, your top five Drain Gang albums are. If you like Ty Boy, you know, obviously I kind of hated on him a bit. If you like him, tell me why in the comments below. Make sure to check out my Patreon if you like what I do. It's one tier, $1. Thank you to my patrons, Favri, Sorame, and Poppy John. Thank you guys so much for supporting the channel. But thank you for watching, and have a good day. Fucking GTBSG, Shield Gang, forever.